sick down in Memphis. We stood at the foot of the pyramid. He had me looking east, had me looking west. Then he sold me a map and said, I wish you the best. And there was Elvis, not the real one. When he told me goodbye, he called me hun. Just another shot in the dark like El Dorado. When Noah's Ark, a girl trying to find herself. The perfect man is like trying to find Atlantis. Sing it up!
It's a mystery, like the deep blue sea. You can take it, you can leave it, but still believe. So I won't give up, and I won't give in. I know I'm on the find it, I just don't know it. The girl trying to find herself, perfect man is like trying to find Atlantis. Woo!
Yeah, you know that's right. Nothing. A girl trying to find herself. Perfect man is like trying to find Atlantis. I said a girl trying to find herself. Perfect man is like trying to find Atlantis. Trying to find Atlantis.
Oh my gosh, thank you guys for being here. This is the my first time playing at the Date Harvest Festival, because, and also this is their first Date Harvest Festival, and I'm so proud to be at the very first one. I'm sure it's going to get bigger and, you know, just more dates with every year that goes by. We've been out there sampling. We've had date shakes. He's been drinking date beer.
I'm still drinking date
beer. If he plays too slow, you know why. He's had too much date beer. And he says that it's like the best thing he's ever had. So there you go. So I went to high school in California, so I love coming back here. It feels like coming home. And thank you guys for coming out to listen to some country music. What about the band before us, Urban Renewal Woo! Project? They
Those
were
guys
amazing.
Were tight.
They were so good.
A couple more of them than there are of us.
Yeah, just a few.
Yeah.
You need to start playing the trumpet or something.
I wish.
Your mouth isn't doing much, so maybe you could try that.
Hello.
What?
Her mouth's running all the time, so it's the opposite.
All right, so I've got a song. After I had my baby girl, when she was just a little toddler, I drove my co-writers crazy because I was like, I really want to write a song that's a salute to moms everywhere, you know, because... Yeah, I mean, they are like heroes, you know, and you sacrifice. It's like you have no idea what you're going to feel like until you have your own child and you think, where was that love hiding my whole life? I've never felt this way before. And it's just that special kind of love and that bond. And so I wrote this song about my daughter and about being a mom, and dedicated to all the moms out there. This one is called Somebody's Hero. Park to a half a million fans screaming out her name. She's never hit a shot to win the game. She's never left her footprints on the moon. Never made a solo hot air balloon ride around the world. But she's just your everyday average girl. She's somebody's hero, a hero to her baby with a skinned up knee. A little kiss is all she needs. The keeper of the Cheerios, the voice.
bedtime stories every night. That smile lets her know, whoa, she's somebody's hero. Oh, she didn't get a check every week like a 9-to-5, but she's been a waiter and a cook and a taxi driver for 20 years there at home. Yeah, until that day her girl was grown. Giving all her love to her was her life's ambition. But now her baby's moving on and she'll soon be missing her. But not today. Those are tears of joy running down her face. She's somebody's hero, a hero to her daughter in the wedding dress. She gave her wings to leave the nest. It hurts to let her baby go. Down the aisle she walks right by, looks back into her mother's eyes. That smile lets her know, whoa, brush through her silver hair. The envy of a nursing home, she drops by every afternoon, feeds her mama with a spoon, and that smile lets her know, whoa, whoa. Her mother's smile lets her know, whoa, whoa. She's somebody's here.
Thank you so much. So do we have any diehard country fans out there? Yes. So what do you feel about Loretta Lynn? Because I love Loretta Lynn. I made a record a few years ago, and I wanted to put all my favorite songs on there. Those the artists that had changed my life because of their songwriting and because of who they are and how where they came from. And I just love doing the Grand Ole Opry, and I love all the traditions that country music has and the roots that we came from. So I wanted to give like a tribute back to those artists and writers. And so I recorded this next song because I love Loretta Lynn. She's so sassy, she still is. This one is called Don't Come Home a Drinking with Lovin' on Your Mind.
You thought I'd be waking up when you came home. You'd been out with all the boys and you ended up half time. Liquor and love, they just don't mix, neither bottle or me behind. And don't come home a drinking with a loving on your mind. Don't come home a drinking with a loving on your mind. Just stay out there on the town and can find. 'Cause if you want that kind of love, well, you don't need none of mine. So don't come home a drinking or with a loving on your mind. You never take me anywhere because you're always gone. Many a night I've laid awake and cried here all alone. When you come in kissing on me, it happens every time. No, don't come home a drinking with a loving on your mind. No, don't come home a drinking with a loving on your mind.
don't come home and drink it with loving on your mind. Stay out there on the town and see what you can find. Yeah, cause if you want that kind of love, you don't need none of mine. So don't come home and drink it with loving on your mind. No, don't come home and drink it.
And this next song is a very cool story about this song. It was written by Kris Kristofferson. And love him. I love his acting. I love his songwriting. I love his voice. I love everything about him. He's a very good-looking man for whatever he is, 80 years old, 70, 75, 76.
He's the best-looking 80-year-old man there ever was.
He must have been, the 60s must have been good to him is all I can say, because he's looking pretty great.
He parted his butt off.
That's what I'm saying. 60s were good to him. So he was living in Nashville, Tennessee, and he was sleeping on Dottie West's couch. When he wrote this song, he was reading an article, and it was Esquire magazine. It was an article on Frank Sinatra. And the guy at Esquire had said to Frank, "What are you into?" And Frank said, "Booze, broads, and the Bible." What a combo, right? A combo? And he said, "Whatever helps me make it through the night." And so Kris went home and wrote this song. He gave it to Dottie West, and she said, "This song is way too suggestive for me. I can't cut it." And she went on to say it was one of her regrets was not cutting this song, because it was a number one record for many artists. Take the ribbon from my hand, shake it loose and let it fall. Lay it soft against my skin, like the shadows on the wall. Come and lay down by my side till the early morning light. All I'm taking is your time. So help me make it through the night. I don't care what's right or wrong, and I won't try to understand. Let the devil take tomorrow, cause tonight tomorrow's outside, and it's sad to be alone. So help me make it through the night. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Help me make it. Yesterday is dead and gone, and tomorrow's out of sight. Yes, it is, and it's sad to be alone. So help me make it through the night. No. so much.
Not too shabby.
So I wrote this next song for girls out there. Believe in yourself. You can make anything happen. And my little girl, when she was about, I don't know, 6, 7 years old, she picked up a guitar, and she wanted to play guitar like her dad. It's her daddy right here. And so we bought her a pink guitar. Yep, this is the old ball and chain right here in the flesh. So we bought her a pink guitar, and you know what? This song became a song that Reba McEntire cut, and I love it because Reba is one of my all-time favorites. And when I heard Reba was cutting pink guitar, man, it blew my mind. So this one is dedicated to any little girls out there who want to be up on stage. Stick to it. You can make dreams happen.
Window just a calling out her name. She mowed the grass, took out the trash, and saved. Bought it on a Monday, had a gig on Friday night. In the garage in front of her mom, she came alive. She likes to play, she loves to ride. Yeah, she's closer to the fire, but she's headed for the top. She's got a dream to be a star, dressed in black like Johnny Cash with a pink guitar. She didn't go to college, she just up and hit the road. Wherever they were jamming, she would go. Every single hole in the wall from here to Shreveport. She'd leave them in the palm of her hand screaming for more. She likes to play, she loves to rock. Yeah, she's closer to the bottom, but she's headed for the top. She's got a dream to be a star, dressed in black like Johnny Cash with a pink guitar. She's gonna play it up there on the Opry stage. Yeah. Soon you'll see it hanging next to Minnie Pearl's hat in the Country Music Hall of Fame. Yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Hey!
She's got a dream to be a star, dressed in black like Johnny Cash. She likes to play, but she loves to rock. Yeah, she's closer to the bottom, but she's headed for the top. She's got a dream to be a star, dressed in black like Johnny Cash with a pink guitar.
A pink guitar.
I said a pink guitar.
A pink guitar.
Oh.
Thank you so much. So, a little husband and wife moment there on stage discussing things as we do. We have been together for 23 years, my friends. And we work together, too. So we are together, and we work in the studio together. So we are together 24/7. And 23 years, I tell you, once you have kids, it goes by in a flash. It feels like 23 minutes.
23 minutes underwater. Huh? Anybody?
Yeah.
No.
Any married men out there that kind of agree with that?
No, I'm just kidding. It's a joke.
So many years ago, I don't know, before I met you, Rod, I guess it was like 1993, maybe? 94? Because we met in 96. I went to a little town called Sedona. Anybody out there been to Sedona? My gosh, one of my all-time favorite moments was driving from Phoenix on my way to the Grand Canyon. I had no idea about Sedona. Nobody had told me about it. And we were on a road trip, and we made that little turn that you make, and there were the red rocks, and there was the church and the rock, and just, oh my gosh, it blew my mind. And so I carried this title around for a long time. I said, I'm going to write a song about Sedona. I'm going to call it Sedona. And I went into my writing appointment that day, and my friend Lisa Drew said, well, I have a title that's from a Stephen King movie, of all things. It was from the movie Dolores Claiborne. And it was a line in the movie, and she said it totally goes with your whole idea about writing about the painted desert and heartbreak and everything like that. So I was playing this song in Bangor, Maine, which is where Stephen King lives. And I told the story. I said, Stephen King inspired this song. Along with all the murderous rage that he has written about, he inspired a country song. Who knew? And a couple months later, I got a signed copy of Dolores Claiborne in the mail and said, Dear Jamie, there really is an Arizona. Signed, Stephen King. And it said, a fan, Stephen King. So I knew that he knew my song, and he approved of it. He never asked for a dime. I never gave him a dime.
I'm glad he didn't. I wouldn't have given him any. I think he's doing all right.
I think he's doing pretty good, too. But we went to see his house, and it's amazing, all the gargoyles. And anyway, so pretty cool. And I have you guys, the fans, to thank for this being my first number one record. So thank you, guys. Thanks for all the letters, too. I got so many letters from girls who had been through this very thing of realizing they were with the wrong man and they needed to wake up to that. So, you know, after heartbreak, we just get a little bit stronger every time. So this one is for anybody out there going through a heartbreak. You will get past it. Promised her a new and better life out in Arizona, underneath the blue, never-ending sky. Sworn that he was gonna get things in order. He'd send for her when he left her behind. It never crossed her mind. There is no Arizona. Postcard with no return address. Postmark tombstone said, I don't know where I'm going next. When I do, I'll let you know. May, June, July. She wonders why she's still waiting. Well, she'll keep waiting, 'cause there is no Arizona. Those dreams he sold her, she'll wake up and find there is no Arizona. Each day the sun sets into the west, her heart sinks lower in her chest, and friends keep asking when she. Desert highway, cool wind in my head, warm smell of calitas rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I saw a shimmering light. My head grew heavy and my sight grew dim. I had to stop for the night. There he stood in the doorway. I heard the mission bell. And I was thinking to myself, this could be heaven or this could be hell. Then he lit up a candle and he showed me the way. And there were voices down the corridor. I thought I heard them say, there is no Arizona, no painted desert. sing it. Thank you so much. Well, you remember that little baby that I was talking about a while back? The funny thing is, she grew up eating dates because I didn't want her to have sugar and candy bars and all that kind of thing. So this kid has probably had more dates than anybody here at the date festival. And it was like her, one of her first words ever. This is our baby girl, Miss Aaliyah Good. Woo! All the way from Nashville, Tennessee. She's 16 now.
What's up, guys? How's everyone doing tonight? Y'all are excited.
I told you he's had too much date beer.
Okay, cool. All right, well, my name is Aaliyah Good. As she said, I'm her daughter, and we've been playing together for a really long time. And I'm super excited to get up and sing for you guys. This one, this is my first song. I wrote this song with a friend of mine. Her name's Gail. She is a singer-songwriter, and it's called Why Would I?
Maybe I like the way I love you. Leisure lives, but I can't help it. I feel nothing. Why can't I miss you like I should? I just can't help when I don't feel something. Something I can't fix. I want more than this. Oh, is it true? I used to need this. Now I feel numbness. Yeah, I do. You say take it or leave it, but boy, I don't live just to please you. How selfish of you to think that I need you. I gave you a shot, but you drink them all up. I can't save you. Well, now I don't have to. And you think that I love you. But why would I want to? I gave you all my heart, everything. All I get is emptiness and no emotion. You couldn't love me as much as you loved yourself. Why do you think you would have all of my devotion? Now something I won't do is walk back toward you. Oh no. You'd say take it or leave it, but boy, I don't live just to please you. How selfish of you to think that I need you. I gave you a shot, but you drink them all up. I can't save you. Well, now I don't have to. And you think that I love you. But why would I want to? Why would I want to? Why should I choose to believe you? 'Cause you want me to bleed.
Thank you.
What else you got?
I wrote
Tell
this,
about this song.
This song. Well, I wrote this when I was dating a guy and I realized that I cannot be his therapist and his girlfriend. I can't be both, you know? I'm not a therapist. I'm not a psychologist. I'm not a psychiatrist. So I realized that, and I was like, you know what? You're going to have to find another person to dump your issues on because it ain't going to be me. Yes, and this one is called Something You're Used To. You had a mom you couldn't talk to and a dad that was never around. You had a heart that's probably broken, and that's why you moved to town. You made me like you. You're kind of cold-hearted because you know. You had a really big house, but you barely left your bed. Forefront over your head. You made me hurt for you. You're kind of cold-hearted because you know that there's just nothing I can do to help you. Sitting in your room just waiting for something that you used to. Yes, I was someone you could use to focus all of your issues. The only one who doesn't give a damn if you don't give. Something I used to. When you're addicted to attention, you can never get enough. You only come around me like a junkie needs a rush. The more that I find out, the more that I think I'm better off now. 'Cause there's just nothing I can do to help you. Sitting in your room just waiting for something that you used to. Guess I was someone you could use to focus all of your issues. The only one who doesn't give a damn if you don't get one to. Guess that's could be the wake up call that you need. But there's just nothing I can do to help you. Sitting in your room just waiting for something that you used to. Guess I was someone you could use to focus all of your issues. The only one who doesn't give a damn if you don't get one to.
Good job, darling.
Thanks, Dad. Thank you.
Thank you. Wait till you hear this one sing, too. Uh-oh. Nope, he's on strike tonight. He said nope. Too many date beers. He doesn't want to have to do a song. We're going to take you back to a little bit of old school. I call this country. Fleetwood Mac and then Dixie Chicks did a great version of this. One of my favorite songs. Of course, Aaliyah's version is my favorite.
Thanks, Mom.
Took my love and took it down. Climbed a mountain and I turned around. And I saw my reflection in the snow-covered hill. Well, the landslide brought me down. Oh, mirror in the sky, what is the roof? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tide? Can I handle the seasons? Well, I've been
Thank you so much. Well, I'm going to do a couple brand new songs for you. I have some new music coming out. I'm so excited about. Plus, it's just cool to have my daughter up here singing with me on these songs. I've been, it's cool to perform them with my full band, but it's really cool to do acoustic too because you really hear the vocals, you know, which is cool. And this is if you can imagine this track, it's pretty like programmed up kind of pop country. Got some banjo on it, that kind of thing. And my new song is coming out next month, and then the whole album's coming out in the spring, so I'm really excited. This one is called Spin the Bottle. It's a liquid pill that puts you to sleep. It's a cherry on top of a 40-hour week. It's a stop at the bar with your buddies on your way home. It's a hell of a buzz when you're 17. It's the courage to talk to the girl of your dreams. It'll tell you yes when everything else says no. It's another round and round we go. And you drink it for thirst. And you drink it to drown. Drink it to sing. Just a little bit louder. Relivation for a silent hangover. It's a self-medication you're taking.
When he says it's over, it's over.
It don't really matter why you tip it back or swallow. It all depends on how you spin the bottle. Make you 10 feet tall on a Saturday night. It'll talk you into a losing fight. It'll shine a different light on a situation. It'll pull the truth out of a lie. Make you confess, make you justify. It's on the time or only on vacation. And you drink it for thirst. And you drink it to drown. Drink it to sing. Just a little bit louder. It's a revelation for a silent hangover. It's a self-medication you're taking.
When he says it's over, it's over.
And it don't really matter why you tip it back or swallow. Yeah, it all depends on how you spin the bottle. It's a vice. Yeah.
Yeah, it all depends on how you spin the bottle. Put you to sleep. It's a cherry on top of a 40-hour week.
It's a stop at the bar with your buddies on your way home.
Thank you so much. Woo. In your case, it's spin the beer bottle, right?
Spin the glass.
Spin the glass, yeah. This one is called Wreck Me. I wrote this with two really good friends of mine. And it's all about giving in and letting your heart get broken and not even caring about it. Just going there, no matter what happens. This one is called Wreck Me. It's never tasted quite like this, burning down with every sin. Innocence and inhibitions lost, crashing through my paper walls, taking over, take it all. Oh, to hell with consequence, oh cost. Oh, I'm already gone, so go ahead and wreck me now. Tell me to pieces, wear me down, throw to the ground, keep stealing my sleep. Go on and make my heart a mess. I think you might be the death of me, but honestly, baby, it's so sweet. Oh, wreck me. You tangled up and twisted me. Early morning sheets, no resemblance to the girl I was. Oh, 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 and I can't get enough.
So go ahead and wreck me now. Tell me to pieces, wear me down.
Throw my defenses to the ground. Keep stealing my sleep.
Go on and make my heart a mess. I think
you might be the death of me, but honestly, baby, it's so sweet. Oh, wreck me. Oh, I'm all in with all I am. Never even stood a chance. Baby, there's no going back. So go ahead and wreck me now. Throw my defenses to the ground.
So go ahead and wreck me now. Tell me to pieces, wear me down.
Throw my defenses to the ground. Keep stealing my sleep.
Go on and make my heart.
Thank you so much. Well, it's Aaliyah's turn to sing a couple more songs for you right now. Go, Aaliyah. Now, she's playing in L.A. next week, so if anybody's driving down to Los Angeles, she'll be at the Hotel Cafe on Thursday night at 7 o'clock.
Yes, I will.
By herself, solo.
Thank you.
wonder if she got lost or they forgot her. She's somebody's daughter. She give up wondering where the cars all go. Can she even tell that I don't know what to say? So I just knock my head and wait. Well, no one's gonna ask what she wants to be or why we're both stuck here at the mercy of geography and whether it shines or rains. Bet she was somebody's best friend, laughing back when she was somebody's sister. Counting change at eliminates him. Probably somebody's high school first kiss. Dancing in a gym where the kids all talk about Sunday plans. Now this light'll turn green and I'll hand her a couple dollars. And I wonder if she got lost or they forgot her. She's somebody's daughter.
You know what? I'm going to do a song that I had a request for. It's very weird to get a request for an Etta James song. Etta James? Oh, that's coming later. Oh, that's still coming. That's coming your way. But this is a song that I wrote. I wrote. What am I saying?
I
don't even know. I wish I'd written this song. I'd be heading out of here in a jet plane. But I did. I was going to say this is a song that I sang for my husband at our wedding. Because we met in our 30s, and yeah, it's pretty cool. Actually, I was 29, you were 30, but we got married when I was 33. And so I sang this song for him, and it's one of my favorites. It's been cut a lot, too. It's called At Last from Etta James. A little R&B for you. At last. My lonely days are over, and life is like a song. Oh yeah, yeah. At last, the sky. A thrill to rest.
cheek to a thrill that I So Aaliyah was really inspired by Avril Lavigne growing up, and still is. She's still growing up, and she's still inspired by Avril Lavigne. Now yes. She's got all that new music out, which is so cool.
This was the first song that I memorized all the words to when I was really, really little, because I grew up, well, I was born when this album, like around the time this album came out. So this was the first song that I listened to, like, all the time and memorized all the words to. Thank you. have some fellow Avril Lavigne fans in the audience.
Yes, knowing all the words, of course. Okay, so we are going to take it up for you a little bit right now. Who's got some room in their heart for some rock and roll, like Journey style? Right? Okay. So this is my favorite karaoke song. Like, if I go out karaoke with my friends, we always sing this song. It's a really fun song. I know you're going to know it, so you got to sing along. Jump along, sing along. It's getting a little chilly, right? Like, this is like cold for Palm Springs. We left 32-degree weather, and we arrived, and it was like 90 here. It's a big, big difference. But it's a dry heat.
It's a dry heat.
Just a small town girl. Took the midnight train going anywhere.
Where's my lead guitar player? Thank y'all so much. All right, we got one more song for you. This is Angels. This is going to go out to you guys. It's going to go out to my friends, my old friend Michelle Tipper, Diana and Larry, Cammie Freeman from high school. Oh, my gosh. She knows where all the skeletons are buried. Anyway, thank you guys so much for being here. It always makes me feel so much better when my best friends are in the crowd. And I thank you guys for making the trek over here and all the way up from L.A. And I love you guys. And we'll see you real soon. Hey, you're going to so enjoy Jenny and the Mexicats. Stick around. They are so awesome. Go out there and sample every date. And make sure you come back next year, all right? This one is also dedicated to my little gal, Miss Aaliyah Good. Give it up for Aaliyah Good, y'all. And Rodney Good on the guitar and vocals.
Woo! Why does the color of my coffee match your eyes? Why do I see you when a stranger passes by? I swear I hear you in the whisper of the wind. I feel you when the sun is dancing on my skin. And when it's raining, you won't find me complaining. Cause when I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. When I think about heaven, taste of sugar sure reminds me of your kiss. I like the way that they both linger on my lips, yeah. Kisses remind me of that field of butterflies. It must be the way my heart is fluttering inside. Beautiful distraction. Hey, you make every thought a chain reaction. When I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. When I think about heaven, I think about California. When I think about angels, I think about you. Anywhere I go, anything I do, now everything around me, babe.
Won't you guys sing it for me one time? Here we go. When I think about rain, when I think about singing, when I think about heaven, I think about angels. When I think about angels, whoa, 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 whoa. When I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. Did I think about you, baby?
The story of Coachella's Best is a very simple one. Our mission at Delray Farms is to grow the best tasting and highest quality medjool dates for you and your family. The Coachella Valley is the best place on earth to grow high quality date products. We're blessed with an abundance and the perfect balance of sun, water, and soil conditions. The growing season for dates is a long one. Harvest only comes once a year. It takes dedicated and experienced working partners to assure growing requirements are met at the right time and in the right way to assure quality. At Delray Farms, we are fortunate to have the best. At our family farm in Coachella, we grow dates organically to ensure a healthy and consistent product packed with necessary vitamins and nutrients, super ingredients to guarantee you are adding to your healthy lifestyle choices. At Delray Farms, we're on a journey to provide you the best date products available. We invite you to join our Coachella Best journey.